my children. Would you stop saying that?
You did? Oh, yes, you did. What's the only thing I asked you to do?
Hey, Dewey J. How you doing, buddy?
Don't you talk to him, Beecham Beauregard Lefette. You talk to me.
I thank you not to use my full Christian name. You're not my mama.
Then quit making me feel like your mama.
I'm saying hello to my brother-in-law. Hey, Dewey J. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, Beecham. You think I should get the Evel Knievel dress-up cape or the official Fonzie leather jacket?
The Fonzie jacket, probably.
I am not talking for my health over here, Beecham.
You could have fooled me. You've been yapping like you're getting paid for it ever since we've been in the car.
Hey, Beecham, you reckon I'm too big for this sit and spin?
It looks pretty small in this picture, Dewey J.
What are you doing?
Circling stuff in that catalog I'm gonna get.
Let me see that. This is a Sears Wish Book catalog from 1979. This thing is older than you are.
It's got real good stuff in it, though.
Yeah, but you're gonna have to time travel to go pick up your order.
You think you can help me do that?
Now you see? This is what I'm talking about. I need you over at the house taking care of Boris Mori so I can focus my full attention here. Dewey J is circling stuff in a catalog circa 1979. If that's not a cry for help, I don't know what is.
Can I have my catalog back?
Harlene is up to her old tricks. Mom's about to lose her house, and my dad's funeral starts in 2 hours. You gotta help me, Beecham, so I can help them.
Have you asked them how they feel?
Of course! I am a trained professional. Dewey J, how do you feel?
Fine.
See?
Okay. Dewey J, how do you feel about your daddy dying?
Real sad, I reckon.
I should say so. He was a real good man.
We did all sorts of things together. I guess I'll probably have to do all that by myself now.
You think maybe you and I could do some of that stuff together?
Yeah.
That'd be okay?
I'd like that.
Well, there you go.
Can you take me to the drugstore later?
Sure, buddy. What do you need at the drugstore?
I won on the lottery last night. I need to cash in my ticket.
Can we do that after the funeral?
Yep. Thanks, Beecham. I feel lots better. Can I have my catalog back?
One down, two to go.
Are you kidding me? I have been trying for days to get that boy to open up to me, and you just swoop in like some psychiatric superhero? Oh, that makes me so mad I could spit nails! But that's besides the point. We have not finished about talking about you leaving the... forgetting the boys!
I didn't forget the boys, and if you say that one more time, I'm gonna...
You're gonna what?
I'll cut off your credit at the country club.
Oh, I dare you! Now, you did forget those boys, Beecham! I swan it's like you're a child yourself! Have to have somebody watching you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week! Makes me want to just claw my face!
You're just mad because Dewey J opened up to me and not to you. Who's the counselor now?
Opened up? It ain't like he spilled his guts to you. Besides, he thinks he won the lottery. Does that sound normal to you? I mean, I know we all cope differently, but come on.
So he won $5 on a scratch-off ticket. What's the big deal?
He did not win the dang lottery. And I will say again, that is besides the point. All I asked you to do is to pick up those boys and give them their dinner. I get home last night and neither you or the boys are nowhere to be found. I had to call all over creation to find out where they were. I can't believe you just dropping them off at the neighbors like that.
Uh-huh. See, I didn't forget the boys. You're just all been out of shape because you didn't know where they were. I mean, far be it from me to make a decision regarding my own children. I had a meeting last night. It's not like I duct taped them to the couch with a juice box and remote.
We will table this discussion for now. But I'm going to tell you what I need from you today. I need you at the house taking care of the boys so I can focus on my family here.
Well, I thought the boys and I were part of your family too.
Morning. Hey, Beecham. Good to see you. Sammy Joe.
Hey, Harleen. Long time no see.
Yeah, that's not. You're looking pretty good.
Yeah, you too, Harley.
Well, great. Now that we're all reacquainted, do you think we can talk about plans for the rest of the day?
What are y'all doing here?
We are leaving here to go to the service. This is where the cars are picking us up.
What cars?
The funeral cars. They come here, they pick up the family, they take you to the church, and then to the cemetery afterwards. Lord Holly, haven't you ever been to a funeral before? What'd you think all those black cars were doing in the front of the line? Leading the presents around town?
It is amazing I never killed you in your sleep when we were younger. Lord, what are they all doing here?
They're waiting for the cars too! Lord Holly, this is not a hard concept to grasp.
Shug, how are you?
Oh, it's gonna be a hard day, Martha Ann, but we'll get there.
Yeah.
You all right?
How many cars are there?
Quit asking me about the cars, Holly.
That answers that question. How's your mama?
I don't know. I haven't seen her yet. I haven't had any time to do anything important like that. Last night, I spent my evening worrying about the whereabouts of my boys, only to find out they weren't 15 feet away. This morning, I spent my time on the phone with Ozella Meeks because Harleen dropped the ball. And I had to get those boys ready for the funeral all by myself because Beecham was sat down on the couch watching Ole Miss play football.
How'd they do?
Well, you know, at first they were getting
high. And I haven't even started on the thank you notes.
So, how's your mama?
I don't know.
She's fine.
Harleen, I seriously doubt that she is fine.
Seemed fine to me.
Well, thank you, Dr. Harleen, for your professional opinion.
I didn't know Harleen was a doctor.
Can I get you something, Benny Charles?
A room with no women in it?
How long are y'all gonna be here?
Until the car pick up the... Why do you care? Oh, you're gonna have some kind of cake party while we're all gone to the service?
You are mean way deep down, Sammy Jo. You know that?
Anybody know what Pong is? Looks all neat and stuff.
Dewey J, you need to get dressed, honey.
I know.
I'll help him. Come on, lady.
Oh, I forgot. Y'all are besties now. Maybe he'll open up to you and tell you about that time he wants friends to serve it.
Did Beecham forget to give you your Xanax smoothie this morning?
Keep it up, Pauline. Just keep it up.